This segment brought to you by the Kansas Soybean Commission, the Soybean Checkoff, progress powered by Kansas farmers.
I'm Matt Perrier, Dalebanks Angus at Eureka, Kansas. Our family is excited to offer 150 of our practical, profitable genetics bulls this November 23rd, so the Saturday before Thanksgiving. We're looking forward to once again showcasing these bulls to commercial cattlemen across the region. It's been 115 years since my great-grandfather started the Angus herd here at Dalebanks, and while we've adopted new technologies and methods of bringing these genetics to the buying public, when we get right down to it, it's probably the same goal that we raise these genetics for commercial cow-calf producers who need them to keep them in business over the long haul. We look for these genetics to offer optimum levels of performance in terms of weaning weight, yearling growth, carcass weight, value, not necessarily maximum. We know that we can probably feed these heavier. We know that we can probably push the edge of the envelope a little harder, but we also know that we've got a cow herd at home that needs to make sure that they're under the optimum levels of performance in terms of reproductive efficiency and structural soundness, so they can make that money at home and us ourselves. When we make selection decisions on genetics here at Dalebanks, we look at it from a customer's point of view, but we look at it from our own point of view as well. Just like you, we are expecting to keep back replacement females every year, and so every mating that we make, we need to be profitable through the feed yard and through the packing plant, but we also need that potential daughter to be profitable at home. And that's something that's extremely important to us and to our customers. So things like foot soundness and structural correctness, udder quality, reproductive efficiency, cow longevity and stayability, all of these things are front of mind when we make these decisions, not just how much output can we put into these cattle. And I think that's important today. Yes, we do need to make revenue off of these cattle, but we also need to make sure that they are keeping their expenses and costs in check as far as a cow herd at home. And so we were some of the first producers in the American Angus Association to enter our cow herd onto Maternal Plus, a whole herd reporting system through the Angus Association. That gives us a lot better handle in terms of heifer pregnancy EPD, eventually stayability EPDs, and these cows that truly do make us more money because of their reproductive efficiency as well as their milking ability and performance. We were also some of the first herds to record foot structure, both claw shape and the pastern angle and claw heel depth, send that into the Angus Association, and today we're going to be one of the first sales in the region to offer these as EPDs on these 150 bulls selling in November. We again think this is something very important as our customers talk to us, and as we look at our own herd, we know that regardless of how many pounds we can put onto that beast, if he or she don't have the proper structure and the proper foot to be able to support that, they're not of a lot of value to us regardless of their genetic level. And so these are all things that, while they may not be sexy to brag about in the catalog, we think they make us money and they make you the customer money as well. So it's very important as we look at these function traits in addition to all of the different EPD levels and pedigrees that we select for. So the bulls this year are going to represent all these traits and the balance that we look for amongst these traits very well. As you look across them, you may not see one bull that's in the top 0.1% of one trait, but you'll see nearly all of the bulls that are in the better half for nearly all the traits. And that's something that we look at as we make our sire selection decisions, our donor cow decisions, replacement female decisions. Basically, all of our genetic selection hinges on the total package. It's optimum levels in a multifaceted set of traits that make the commercial cow-calf producer money and hopefully make us money as well. So once again, we invite you to join us on November 23rd for our practical, profitable genetics bull sale here at our new marketing facility northwest of Eureka, Kansas.
Kansas Corn reminds you that E15 fuel is the right choice for every kind of driver. For the car enthusiast, E15 has higher octane. For the thrifty driver, E15 is priced lower than regular unleaded. For the nature lover, E15 provides cleaner air. For the shopper who buys local, E15 has more ethanol from our Kansas corn farms. Choose E15 for a higher octane, lower price, cleaner American fuel. Message from the Kansas Corn Commission. Learn more at kscorn.com.